You would not believe how long I had to spend grinding for souls.
I must have made the most out of taking slow, cause now I'm back to living fast, fast as I can go. Yet it chills me to the bone, knowing how I'm not alone, and that you can have a dark soul with a heart of gold.
Got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too safe. Got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too safe. Got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too safe. Flames parallel to hell, but I must maintain.
This is me when I'm talking to myself. Get up, humiliated, degraded, so what? Get up, ashamed that you've been played and betrayed. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Get up, get up, get up.
Get up, get up.
Welcome back, everyone. I recorded episode 10 maybe, good golly, maybe what, 4 days ago now? And so for the last 4 days, I've just been grinding off camera for souls, doing lots and lots of co-op, primarily to get souls, obviously, but primarily so I can reacquaint myself with the upcoming areas. But before we do all that, let's go ahead and make our way up here, because there is a very interesting enemy we want to take out right now. Familiar enemy for those of you who have played Dark Souls 1. For those who started with Dark Souls 2 and did not play Dark Souls 1, it'll be kind of a new territory for all y'all. And that was kind of a weird sudden light change right there. But there's absolutely no guarantee I'll beat him. Actually, before I go ahead and take... Well, there he is. But first, before we do that, I just want to show my build off again one more time. I pumped the hell out of my luck. I gave myself 20 intelligence and faith. The luck is mainly just so I can prepare myself to use a very good weapon. Actually, I did mention it already. I'm preparing to make this a build that revolves around Henri's straight sword. But we're going to go ahead and fight this stray demon right here. Woo! Alright. Doing fairly good damage, gotta say. Woo! Not sure if I want to lock on. I'm still thinking about it! Woo! I'm sorry, I guess I just started the episode and I feel bad for having to start with quiet time already, but I just want to make sure I don't die to this guy. Whew. So, as per usual for Dark Souls 1... Oh! Can I... Aw, I bet you can critical him. Oh, he breaks apart? Oh, he didn't break apart for... I don't remember... When I first fought him, I don't think he broke apart like that. That's really cool. But anyway, we got the soul of the stray demon. Got a bunch of relatively useless items for the Great Axe, but our build's not going to be able to use it anyway. In that downtime, though, I did a whole lot of experimentation with this build. I tried doing a magical infusion with this weapon, and it turned out it was actually not very good for the upcoming areas, even though it's really good for my current build. I did a whole lot of co-op, so I know the next couple of areas pretty well. Actually, the irony of it all is I actually did not... prepare myself for this area, but I figured it can't be that hard, right? But the next area, the one that leads on from the cleansing chapel, that other bonfire we got, I think, last episode, that area I know pretty damn well. Let's go take care of this little bastard right here. Oh, yeah. All right, that's one. Large Titan Shard. We actually do need those for our next level up for this weapon. Large. I think we need three, though. That's the thing. Dragon Crest Shield. That's got good fire resistance. But I don't think we'll be fighting anybody that uses it. Ooh, this could be pretty useful for our build. But I still want to hold on to heal for a little while longer, because it does help me out when I'm running low on Estus. And if you'll notice, too, my Estus has 9 now. I did a clever little skip. Damn you. Ooh, nice heavy gem. Not that we'll really be needing it. Nice, Parry King. I did a little skip to the top of Firelink Shrine. Not really the top, just the roof. And I got myself an Estus Shard there, but I didn't want to explore the rest of the area because I wanted to save it for this video, or at least some video in the near future. All right, take a swig. So I got 9 drinks. I'm so used to having only 4 drinks though because of all the co-op I've been doing. Fuck you. I'm the Parry King. Oh, boy. Ah, so much for Parry King, huh? Is there any items over here? What the hell is that? Is that a pilgrim? It's a super dead pilgrim. I don't know if I'd noticed him before. He's a different color than the normal pilgrims as well. Ooh, that reminds me. I gotta review that quest line again, because I was also sort of, I was actually basically studying the quest lines that I am trying to complete in this run. I guess I'm dropping down this way, huh? Alright, so that's it for this area. We can go ahead and pop the Soul of the Stray Demon, or we could just save it, because I don't plan on really using any boss weapons in this run anyway. I did get one, but I don't really know if it's all that useful. Let's check it out first. It's the Crystal Sage Rapier. Oops, whoa, what the heck? I didn't know you can sort your stuff? I didn't know that. Alright, it's not much, it doesn't increase our stats very much. It's kind of close, but not great. Not better than our raw Stora sword. Alright, so let's head back. We're gonna head back to Firelink first, and then we're gonna take on the boss at some point in this episode. I want to take on this boss in this episode. Good golly, I was trying to say take him on and take on the boss. Jesus, man, I can't fucking talk. To be fair, though, I usually don't wait this long between episodes to record. Actually, let me see what new spells I can use. I can use that burst fireball. I don't know if that's any good. Homeward's pretty useful. Ooh, I got medium heal now, don't I? Okay, I might as well switch that sucker out. I still don't really want to use Soul Arrow. I can use Magic Weapon again. I took it off because I tried that Magic Infusion. But for the boss that I plan on taking on this episode, I guess it could be useful. Yeah, let's try it. Why not? I did not increase my attunement at all. Oh, wait, I'm just going to leave. Duh. So let's go ahead and head back to Firelink. Then we'll take on the boss. Trying to remember where exactly the right area to go in that swamp, because that area we did snuff out all those candles like we were supposed to do, but we also had to go to that door that unlocked, and I can't remember. I told myself that it's near this bonfire. Like, if we just descend the ladder, it should be near that bonfire. So let's first see how many large tiny. I think we only had two, right? Yeah, we only had two. I'm pretty sure we need three, but let's just double check just to be absolutely safe. Reinforce. Oh, we can. It only takes two. Sick. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. Yeah. It's been a little while since we upgraded this sucker, too. I don't know if there's any large Titanite shards in the next area, though. Like, in the next few areas, though. Which is a damn shame. I mean, I guess it's kind of the game's way, like, the way it was designed to sort of go at the pace that they want you to, at least as far as upgrades go. Unless you had a very cool friend who likes to drop you off weapons through co-op, you know. That's a thing that they, good golly, load already. That's a thing that they tried to mitigate in Dark Souls 2 by putting, like, equipment requirements on armor. I guess stat requirements. So this is the tower key, and this is where the tower key opens, and we get a few nice things up in here. And we also meet an NPC as a result of it. The thing is, I have never been up here since the first time I did it. First, let's go this way before we do anything else. So we can meet the crows with this game. Actually, first, let me kick down this ladder. You can actually come up here without the ladder. That's the skip I was telling you about. Not really a skip, but if you jump at that tree over there, you can. If you sort of run up it, like, ever so slightly, and then you jump off, you can make it to the roof over here and grab that item. But first, we're going to get a very important thing. It's not super important, but it's pretty damn important to me. Let's drop off. Where are you at? One of these. Pickle P. We got call over, one of the single greatest gestures. Oh, I didn't know. I forgot we got the iron braces because of that, too. That'll be useful for when I'm co-oping, when I'm grinding for souls. It's actually pretty good just because it actually makes a sound. Where the hell is it? There you are. Hey. My main character says here, though, so I guess it's kind of random. Let's see what else we can drop real quick. I don't want to mess around with it too long, but I bet you. Damn, I got a lot of my metals. Let's leave one, see if it does something. Nope, didn't think so. Alright, no matter. Let's go ahead and see if there's other stuff I can grab. I think there's an area behind Firelink I can go to. I think there's a crystal lizard, actually. Yeah, there is. Get over here. Gem? I think it's a gem. No, it's Twinkling Titanite. Excellent. Anything else back here? Don't believe so. And it leads us back right over here again. So we just go ahead and make our way up. We'll grab the stuff over here, meet our NPC buddy, who's not so much of our buddy, but, you know, as, you know, if you played a Souls game within the last 5 years, you already know who this guy is. Let's go and take this. Take care of this first of all. I don't remember there being an elevator here. Oh, I remember what this gets you. This gets you an item for your firekeeper. No treasure ahead. Yeah, I do seem to remember that. They got a lot of empty areas that you'd assume they're just random treasures and trinkets, but they're actually is not. Firekeeper's soul, that's what it was. Duh. Very important item in the first Dark Souls game because it allows you to upgrade your Estus flask. Firekeeper's soul. Oh yeah, that allows us. Okay, so we didn't actually need to get that because that'll actually ruin our quest line here. The Firekeeper's soul will allow the Firekeeper to cure us of our dark sigils. Good golly. Oh, he's not here. That wasn't supposed to happen. You're supposed to be here. We're supposed to be locked away by patches here. Oh, you know, I bet you I know why. Because we got to the cleansing chapel, and I think we're supposed to meet him around there anyway. But since we got there before, since we unlocked the tower relatively late, I think he's just not going to show up. Which is weird. I thought, because that's how it happened for me though on my first profile. But this is the way they didn't want you to go down, because you are more than likely to kill yourself if you're not careful. Gonna play it safe. Taking my time. Not gonna have another friggin' Cathedral Ward incident. And we get the Estus Ring. Very good ring. Very useful ring. I could have sworn friggin' Patches was gonna be here. That sucks. Whoa, what the hell's that? That was not there before. Was it? Did I just not get it? Am I an idiot? What the hell, man? How did I miss that? It had a bright, glowy, whatever the fuck. Alright, let's go see if Patches is up here anyway, because he's supposed to show up. That's strange. Oops. Because what happens is he locks you out of that gate that I showed you, and then you gotta force him to make amends, but yeah, he's not here. Weird. Okay, well. Oh, I also got the covetous silver serpent ring. You also get that from jumping around up top and then messing around with shit. But anyway. Okay, I guess that's really it, huh? That's weird. Alright, let's go ahead and take on the boss of this area. I want to say this is closer, but I don't remember. Let's just go here. I'm going to trust my gut. This next boss is probably the prototypical example of what I mentioned before of how the bosses in the game don't seem terribly hard, but they're just really, really fun to fight, you know? They're really interesting fights, they're really, really fun fights. Excuse me. Seriously, hope I'm recording, good golly. I never knew how to get the hello carving. I think you have to drop something off of one of the crows. Alright, so let's go ahead and climb down this ladder if I can remember how to get to it. There we go. Not so much climb as we are just gonna slide. Fucking slugs, man. Whew. Oh, that's some bullshit. Alright, I swore it was around here. Oh, it's right there. Okay, so we're gonna go through this way. Thing is about this area, though. Crawling a lot with these transformy crow men people. We saw them before. But I'm gonna fuck this guy up. Oh shit. Alright, it worked out. These guys don't seem aggroed until the spellcaster guy aggroes them. My stamina! Okay, there we go. Alright, there's an item over here. Probably something useless, probably just souls. Ooh, Shriving Stone. Again, allows us to revert our item or our weapon back to normal state. In case you want your scaling back, your damage scaling. Now this area is pretty damn cool. In fact, I'm gonna let this guy live, and I'm gonna show you exactly what he does. Because what's cool is about these dark rays, and I think I fought one last episode or the episode before. But I'm just gonna have him. Yeah, if you take a look, they're actually gonna fight. It's really, really cool. So let's go ahead and let those guys mess each other up. With luck, at least one of them will die. But this way, first of all, leads to another bonfire. Hello, Adam. There's a deliberate reason why I wasn't responding to you. Yes, I cannot right now. This area leads to that Black Knight we saw earlier, but we'll tackle this here when we get there. Hey, Adam. I'll be down in approximately 15 minutes.
Hello.
Have you seen this area before?
What's this one?
This is the, I forget the name of the area, but the Crucifixion Woods. But the Dark Race, these guys, they actually fight other enemies
for you. Yeah. I'm watching my friend do this one.
It's really cool. I like this area. Okay, so we lucked out, and the other one died, and this one is almost... Ah, damn, I want his items.
This is the area with the...
Damn it.
With all the guys, like, the multiple people.
Yeah.
The boss, right?
Yeah, don't spoil it. I'm kidding. They're about to see in a bit. But yeah, this area is like a it's kind of a two-on-two boss fight. It's really interesting. But let's first clear out this area. What I was hoping to get from the Dark Race was, at the very least, the Dark Sword. It's considered one of the strongest weapons in PvP right now. I don't really understand why, but it just feels good. Well, because one, it's a special weapon. You can you have to get special Titanite to upgrade it. But also, I'll summon that guy in a bit. Actually, that's not even the NPC I'm looking for. Because you can also buff it as well. God damn it. Alright, it's not going the way I had intended. Damn it! I wish I had some poison moss. Yeah, purple moss. Guard break! There we go. Alright, I took the hit, but at least I tanked through it. Backstab! Backstab? There we go, guard break. Alright, that wasn't so bad. There's only one more of these guys here, but I would rather not go in poison. I don't have any freaking purple moss limbs.
Well, it's your own fault, isn't it?
Is this the NPC? Oh yeah, it is. Blackhand Goddard. That is the NPC. Okay, cool.
Who's that?
He's just an NPC. Oh, I can. I can summon Cirrus also. Sick.
This Alex.
Oh my god. Oh my god. That's on the fucking recording, man.
Good.
Oh my god, dude. That's right. Jesus, what's your fucking? Oh my god, it smells!
I don't like how you're smelling thing.
I thought I smelled it for a sec, so I'm a little scared.
I think it's your upper lip.
Wow, okay, that joke. I was gonna say though. Alright, I'm gonna backstab this. Ah, shit. Alright, fine. I know if you kill these guys, you can farm hollow gems, but I think it's a very rare drop. Hollow gems is very good for luck based builds, but actually, I might consider doing that if for some odd reason, Honorary Sword doesn't work. What's that?
Is this a new game already?
Yeah, this is my, this is the same one you saw me farming on earlier.
Yeah, no, is this, like, you beat the game, it's the new one?
Yeah. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, so, I'm going to go ahead and summon these guys, because I already beat this guy solo, and I don't feel bad about summoning. But this fight, if you have the chance, definitely fight this fight solo. It's
like,
really goddamn fun.
Do you, lose experience from it?
No, you just lose, quote-unquote, internet street cred.
I don't get it.
People will totally chastise you if you say, oh, you didn't fight him solo, you didn't get the true Dark Souls experience, blah, 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 blah. Where's Cirrus' sign?
If it wasn't,
just see it?
It wasn't true Dark Souls, why would it
be? Oh, yes! Forgot.
What?
I got a gesture for summoning. Where's that last sign? Can I not summon Cirrus anymore?
No.
I can't summon two NPCs at the same time?
Evidently, no.
Alright, well then, fuck Goddard. Fuck you, you piece of shit. I got what I wanted from you. Okay, we're gonna summon Cirrus, though.
What'd you get from him?
I got a gesture from him. Actually, I like that gesture a little bit more than Legion etiquette. Let me see if I can find it. Is this it? Yeah, by my sword. Neato. So this is an NPC I didn't get in my first playthrough because, one, I didn't know I could summon her, and two, I totally made her hate me because I joined a covenant that she wasn't a part of, or the opposite covenant, the rival covenant. It's like because I didn't know that would happen. It's like a Jets versus the Sharks kind of thing. Mm-hmm. This fight is really goddamn fun, man. I love this fight. But actually, there's a whole lot of fights. There's a lot of humanoid fights in this game, and they're really, really fun to fight solo. But
I don't understand why they fight each other.
See, I don't know because I feel like until I open that door. I mean, I don't know the lore behind it. I didn't read any of it, but like, I feel like that they were just locked in a basic purgatory in this room, essentially. Especially since they all keep rising and resurrecting and whatnot, they have nothing better to do but fight, I think. I don't know. Are you familiar with Artorias, Adam, from Dark Souls 1?
No.
Artorias was a character who traversed the Abyss, became corrupted in the supposedly... he basically saved the world, kind of, from the Abyss. But it turns out you were the person who took his legend, you just blamed it on... You did a Batman thing, you did a Harvey Dent on him, basically. But anyway, these guys are like the inheritors to his... They basically made a covenant around him. I'm invaded? Who's gonna invade me? Well, they can't invade me anymore because I'm in the middle of a boss fight. Oh, I forgot to buff.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did. Save me, Sirius! Damn you!
Oh, wow, that's a
huge. Let's see, the nice thing about this boss, though, he staggers pretty easily. Oh, wait! Does the extra one not come around if I have an NPC summoned? I'm pretty sure you can. I thought you could parry him. I know you can backstab him, but I thought you. Oh, shit! He staggers like a motherfucker, man. Even in his second phase! Ah! Sirius, I swear to God, you better not die. The only reason I summoned you because I thought it would advance your questline. That's basically Stinger, wasn't it? Damn it, he hits hard. His sword, too, that you get for beating him, or for using his soul to make a weapon, is, like, seriously one of the most popular weapons for, like, scrubs to use in PvP. It's kind of funny.
Oh, the fire
one? Just the sword and the hook that he has. Yeah, unfortunately, it doesn't light on fire in-game.
That one?
Yeah. Yeah. People use that all the goddamn time. Even before the game came out in the US, when people were just importing it and whatnot from Japan, everyone was using that one. Everyone and their mother was using that weapon in PvP. Well, I mean, not our mother, but, you know. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what she's doing. I think it looks like he's absorbing the abyss out of his comrades or whatnot, but I don't really know. Go ahead and take care of that real quick. Oh, is his blade serrated? It looked like it was serrated for a sec. I think that's just the pixelation. Yeah. Alright, after this recording, I'll get some food, man. Goddamn starving. But this is where the fight gets actually really interesting. Because, well, what you didn't get a chance to see, though, is one of his comrades will fight him, while another one of him joins him. It's a 2-on-2, like I said. If you didn't have Sirius, it'd be a 2-on-2 fight. And it's really, really cool. I should probably heal. I still got my buff. And he still staggers just like before, but the thing is... Ah, shit! This fight becomes a lot like the Maria fight from Bloodborne, the old hunters. Not a whole lot of like. What do you want? No, I wasn't talking. Well, I mean, I was talking to Adam. I was talking to. Okay, bye, Claudia. That was Claudia, everyone. Ah! Oh my god. He still, like I said before, he still staggers. Ah! Still staggers pretty easily. As long as you can get the first hit off, you'll be okay. Now, you shouldn't do what I did on my first playthrough. I just literally used the greatsword to fight him. I mean, it's not impossible, but you really got to use less strikes, especially since it uses up a whole lot of stamina. Now, I'm pretty sure I don't need to summon Sirius to advance her questline, but I think I know they're... Ah, shit, you ass! Don't be greedy, dash attack! GG. Thanks, Sirius. So that was our first Lord of Cinder we've ever beaten in this playthrough. Where are you going? Alright, see you later. And with that, we're actually pretty close to time, and especially I gotta go get dinner anyway. But let's go ahead and unlock this next area, and then we'll call it an episode. See, I'm not sure what that chalice is. I bet you any money that that allows you to get to the DLC whenever it comes out. Even though it sort of opens a staircase here and you can't really get back to this, but... I don't know, I feel like that chalice is important. And this is the Karthus something or other ruins? Catacombs of Karthus. Karthus. And this will actually be where we advance Henri's questline next. So let's go ahead and head back to Fireland. Actually, let's go ahead and rest, and we'll call it an episode. I'm getting really close to time anyway, like I said. So, thanks so much for watching. It was kind of non-traditional episode today, but anyway, thanks so much for watching, you guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.